Since radiation has many important applications, for example, radiation therapy that is used in medicine, it is very important to be able to measure and quantify how much radiation is produced by some radioactive source or how much radiation is absorbed by some type of substance or material. Now, the subject that deals with measuring and quantifying radiation is known as dosimetry, and that's exactly what we're going to concern ourselves in this lecture. So we're going to discuss four important terms that we must know whenever conducting dosimetry, whenever dealing with dosimetry. And let's begin by defining the source activity or the activity of our source. Now, what exactly is a source? Well, the source is basically some type of radioactive isotope or nuclei that readily undergoes radioactive decay and in the process releasing radiation. Now, the source activity, or simply the activity, is the number of nuclei that decay every single second. And there are two units that we must be aware of when dealing with the source activity. Unit number one is known as the Curie, and unit number two is known as the Becquerel. So one Curie is equal to 3.70 times 10 to the 10 decays every single second, and this is a relatively old unit. The modern day unit is the Becquerel, and one Becquerel is equal to simply one decay every single second. Now, what exactly does the magnitude of the activity actually depend on? Well, we actually discussed this part when we spoke about half-life and radioactivity. So the magnitude of the activity of our radioactive source depends on two things. Firstly, it depends on the total number of radioactive nuclei that have not yet undergone radioactive decay at that moment in time, and it's designated by uppercase N. Now, the half-life of our radioactive isotope also determines the magnitude, and the equation that gives us the source activity given by uppercase R is given by this formula. So 0.693 divided by the half-life multiplied by uppercase N. So let's move on to the next important term. So let's discuss something known as the absorbed dose, also known as the exposure. So let's suppose we have some type of source, some type of radioactive isotope that readily undergoes decay. So as it decays, it basically releases radiation into the surrounding atmosphere, into the surrounding area. And as that radiation is released, that radiation interacts with the substance found in the surrounding area. And so that material or substance can absorb some of that radiation. And the absorbed dose basically describes how much radiation is absorbed by that surrounding material. Now, the old unit that describes the absorbed dose is known as the Rentgen. The Rentgen basically describes how much energy in joules is deposited by that radiation, is transferred by that radiation to the surrounding air. And one Rentgen is defined as 0.878 times 10 to the negative 2 joules of energy that is transferred into 1 kilogram of the surrounding air. So once again, and it's the amount of radiation that is transferred specifically by X-rays or gamma rays. Now, because we have many different types of radiation other than X-rays and gamma rays, and because not only air, but other types of substances and materials can also absorb radiation, we no longer use the Rontgen. We use something called the RAD. So the modern unit of absorbed dose is known as the RAD. So basically, the RAD, which is given by uppercase R, describes how much energy is deposited by the radiation into some type of material per kilogram of that material. And one rad is equal to 1.00 times 10 to the negative 2 joules of energy that is absorbed by 1 kilogram of that substance. Now, our rad is not the SI unit of absorbed dose. The SI unit of absorbed dose or exposure is the gray. And one gray is equal to 1 joule of energy that is absorbed by 1 kilogram of surrounding material of our object that is absorbing by that radiation. And this is equal to 100 rads. Now, notice the rad is given by uppercase R, but this is not the same thing as this uppercase R. This uppercase R has units of the becquerel, and it designates the source activity or the activity of our source. This uppercase R designates the absorbed dose. It's how many joules of energy is absorbed by 1 kilogram of our substance. So once again, the gray and the rad tell us how much energy is absorbed by 1 kilogram of any type of material. For example, this whiteboard, our marker, the skin, the bones in our body, and so on. Now, the question is, or the question that I want to pose is the following. What exactly determines how much radiation is absorbed by some object? So, not only does the type of radiation determine how much energy is absorbed by a given object, but also the type of material that we are using also determines how much radiation is absorbed. For example, if we take X-rays and direct X-rays at our body, most of that radiation will be absorbed by the bones of the body and not by the skin and the cells between the skin and the bone. So not only does a type of radiation determine how much of that energy is absorbed, but also the type of material we are using determines how much energy is absorbed, what our absorbed dose is. So the question is, what exactly determines the actual damage that is caused by radiation? Remember, when radiation passes through matter, it damages that matter. It breaks the bonds and damages that structure as a whole. And something called the quality factor is used to describe how much damage is actually caused. So basically, the gray and the red do not really tell us how much damage is caused to our absorbing material. It only tells us how much of that energy is simply absorbed. Now, the quality factor of any radiation is the number of rads of X-ray or gamma radiation that produces the same damage as one rad of that given substance. So we arbitrarily choose the quality factor of X-rays or gamma rays to equal 1. So basically, what this means is the following. So since we're using X-rays or gamma rays, that means one rad of gamma rays or X-rays needs to be used to produce the same damage as one rad of gamma or X-rays. So that makes sense. Now, however, if we examine the QF, the quality factor of a different type of radiation, for example, alpha particles, we see that the QF is equal to 20. And that means we basically need 20 rands of X-ray radiation to produce the same damage that is caused by 1 rad of alpha radiation. So alpha radiation causes much more damage than X-rays or gamma radiation. And finally, let's define something called the effective dose. The effective dose is simply the product of the number of rads of radiation we are using and the QF, the quality factor of that radiation. And the units of this is known as REM, R-E-M.